Hello everybody, I'm Romain, I am interventional cardiology in Brest. So today I'm a pleasure to be with Martin Gillard from Brest, France, also interventional cardiologist. So today we are all together to discuss how to easily reduce radiation exposure in your cath lab. So we have 5 minutes to convince Martin. So we all know that the optimal distance between the tube and the detector should be around 1 meter. But in daily practice, it's very difficult to always maintain this distance, for example, in STEMI patient or in complex and long procedure. How you manage this issue, Martin, in your daily practice?
I agree. It's a very good point. In order to maintain the capture door close to the patient, whatever the incidence, GE develop the Innovascence. Innovascence is an automatic patient contouring system that select the optimal position for the image receptor according to the patient. So the detector could move away or close to the patient with any additional manual adjustment by the physician. Finally, the receptor stay close to the patient at all time during the procedure. It is important to note that this system allow to keep the target source to the image distance in a good level, even in a patient with high BMI, as you can see in the graphs. So now we can have a movie in order to explain, because it's not so easy to explain. And you can see here, when the physician is modified the eye of the table, the receptor is following the patient, but it is automatic. And now, when the physician is moving to go to LAO or to REO, as you can see here, the receptor is also automatically go very, very near the patient and without touch the patient, because it's also, this is important in the procedure. And you can see it's very, very easy to have every time the receptor close to the patient without any modification of ourselves.
Thank you, Martin. It's very clear. So we already discussed before, with the increasing duration of the procedure time, the fluoroscopy time is also increasing. And usually we use a 15 frame rate, usually in the daily practice. But did you think we need to use that routinely?
No, for me, it's no more useful. We have the possibility to use a 3.75 frame rate in daily practice for the majority of the procedure without major reduction of the quality of the image. This is important. So indeed, to compensate for a possible reduction in image quality with a low frame rate, the authorized system developed by GE is an intelligent image chain, allowing to maintain a good image resolution in the 3.75 frame rate. So it's very important. And you can see here in this graph that we significantly reduce the dose exposure for each type of procedure, actually.
Martin, we have discussed how to reduce the dose during the procedure. So we usually report the dose IRA product, but as we know, it doesn't reflect the skin dose of the patient. So in your daily practice, how you assess the skin dose received by your patient?
So we have the dose map. The dose map is a feature used to calculate, display, and record an estimated local cumulated dose during procedure. It is designed to provide to the user a visualization of the distribution of the skin dose through the procedure. For example, we show 4 patients with the same DAP. Patient 2 has a very moderate skin dose because it is diffused over a large area. While for the patient 4, this dose is much higher because it is concentrated on a small area, probably due to the fact that we have been working for a long time with the same incidence. By this way, with the dose map, we can modify the incidence when the procedure is long, because we see this kind of information.
Thank you, Martin. It's very clear. So now it's time to summarize. Could you give us your take-home message?
So we have seen the robotic assistance to reduce the distance from receptor to patient in a sense. We have seen also the importance of intelligent chain image, allowing to use a 3.75 frame rate in fluoro. And also we have seen the visualization of the distribution of local accumulated dose, which is very important, the dose map. In order to this result in easy and automatic patient and physician reduction dose.
Thank you, Martin.